the, to be part of the introduction to the 16 fundamentals of the Assemblies of God. This is 5, the salvation of man.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. If you remember last week, Dan was talking about the fall of man. So because of that, this is the salvation of man. Okay, so number 5, the salvation of man. Man only hope of redemption through the shed blood of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. And that's what Jesus came to be. Now, it says here, the conditions of salvation. Salvation is received through repentance toward God and faith towards the Lord Jesus Christ by the washing and regeneration and the renewing of the Holy Spirit. Being justified by grace through faith, man becomes an heir of God according to the hope of eternal life. That means because we're part of the family, we're princesses and princes.
That's right.
We're royalty of the kingdomly realm, of the heavenly realm that's out of this earth. Praise the Lord, we have a destination, and this ain't it.
That's right.
That's right.
So, Luke 24:47. Can you read that? It's on the back. You guys follow along. This is all the same stuff you have there.
You ready?
Yeah.
Then he said to them, "Thus it is written, and thus it was necessary for the Christ to suffer and to rise from the dead the third day, and that repentance and remission of sins should be preached in his name to all nations, beginning at Jerusalem."
Okay. It starts with repentance, guys. It starts with recognizing our fall, what Dan was talking about last week. The fall of men, how deprived we are, how unacceptable we are, but through the blood and our faith in Jesus Christ, his work, we are redeemed.
Yeah.
Amen. John 3:3, can you read that, Gracie?
Jesus answered and said to him, "Most assuredly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God."
Born again. Everybody's here is born again. And guys, just like Dan was talking last week, when men fell, I think it was Ashley. You said that our spirit was the thing that died, right? In the garden? So that was it. That was our death. That our spirit, everybody born is born spiritually dead. And through Jesus Christ, we're given the spirit, the whole new spirit that's alive. Our spirit within us is alive. And when we ask the Holy Spirit to come in us, he's the driver, guys. He's the one that leads us into his will be done here on earth.
Come on.
Romans 10:13-15. Ashley, could you read that, please?
Yes, sir. "For whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. How then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? How shall they hear without a preacher? How shall they preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who preach the gospel of peace, who bring glad tidings of good things."
Amen. That's you guys. Okay, so it was said, this is pretty cool. And we might have mentioned it here. We might have, I've not heard it, but it's been said that we should preach the gospel every day. Every day preach the gospel.
Right.
And if necessary, use words.
Yeah.
What does that mean? It means we live it out through love, through our knowledge of Jesus Christ, our repentance, living a repentant life of let's walk according to what the Spirit wants us to do.
Amen.
Okay, Ephesians 2:8. Can you read that, Deb?
Yeah. "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and not of yourselves. It is the gift of God."
Amen, dude. So listen, guys. I heard a little brother talk to me earlier about how we struggle and how, yeah, it is hard for us, but God, nothing's impossible for God.
That's right.
You know, and it's, we rest on him. That's our hope. That's our rest. He's our Sabbath. But it's not ourselves, lest any man should boast. We can bring nothing to this. It's not, Jesus Christ is going to save me, but I got to try really hard and get up every morning and do this and do that. No, it's Jesus Christ, period. Because of our love and obedience, we should get up every morning and learn more about him and get to know him more. That way we become stronger in faith and stronger in the knowledge that we can live through him, for him, and by him. Amen. Okay, that was okay. Titus 2:11. Titus.
For the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men.
For the grace of God that brings salvation to all men.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Titus 3:5-7. Levi, could you read that, please?
Not by work. Not by works of righteousness, which we have done, but according to His mercy, He saved us just there
take over for him. Not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy he saved us through the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Spirit, whom he poured out on us abundantly through Jesus Christ our Savior, that having been justified by his grace we should become heirs according to the hope of eternal life.
That's our hope. Yes. That's our hope, eternal life. And I don't know how it's going to be in heaven, but it's going to be all about Jesus. And it's going to be awesome. I don't know what we're going to do there, but I know we get to know him better. I know we get to live our life perfectly, not struggle like we do on earth here, like we do every day, right? Okay, so that was the condition of salvation. That's so basically, what do we have to do to get saved?
Repent.
That's pretty much it. And say, Lord, you're the King, you're the boss. Holy Spirit, guide me and lead me. It's your life. We surrender, right? Repent, surrender, and let the Lord Spirit lead us. Now, the evidence of salvation, the inward evidence of salvation is a direct witness of the Spirit. Romans 8:16.
The Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God.
Yeah. Amen. You'll have that when we start walking in the Spirit. You'll see the Spirit. It's not, it didn't come from you, Titus. It didn't come from you, Paley. It came from the Holy Spirit. It came from God himself through you to love somebody. Because God calls us to love, right?
Yes.
Ephesians 4:24. Go ahead, Freely. Okay, the new man, right? So this is another proof of what we should strive for and grow into. So I'm going to read this. This is the character of a new man found in Colossians 3:12-17. It's not on the paper. This is like a little bonus. Okay, so it says, therefore, now this is, you ask, so what's it look like, right? This is what we should be looking in the mirror, okay? Therefore, as elect of God, holy and beloved,
page 12,
put on tender mercies, kindness, humility, meekness, long-suffering, bearing with one another, the forgiveness of one another. If anyone has a complaint against you, even as Christ forgave you, you also must do. But above all these, put on love, which is the bond of perfection, and let the peace of God rule your hearts, to which also you have called in one body, and that's the church. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. And whatever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God through Father giving thanks to God the Father through him.
Amen.
That's it. Colossians 3, 12 and 17. So it's like, God, what do you want me to do? Read Colossians 3. Read the last one, sweetheart. Titus 2, 12. Denying ungodliness.
Ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live worldly, righteous and godly in the present age.
So that's, okay, again, that's the evidence of what we should live. Guys, we're not going to be perfect. We're going to fail. We're going to fall. But our strive, our growth is to be more like Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
To not live as the world lives. Not to live with worldly lusts and, you know, drunk or out of our minds, but righteously in the presence of our God. So it was said, what's evil, right? What's evil? Okay, let's back up again.
Yep.
What's darkness?
Absence of God.
Light. Absence of light. Right? So evil is absence of holiness. I believe you said that, Dan.
Absence of God.
Yeah. So let's be light. Let's be the light of this world, in this dark world. Let's be light. So even though we're not perfect, even though we fail and we can't be in those cruddy dark corners sometimes, we still have that light that Jesus synthesized that we can let it show. Let your light shine in those dark places and maybe bring conviction to a friend, to a family member, to something, not in hate, not in judgy, but in love. And it's like, this is Jesus Christ, he loves you, and I love you. And wow, man, this guy is like, loves God, and he's like, he's in the muck with me. You know what I mean? That's it. Like I said before, you know, preach the gospel every day. We're called to do that. And if necessary, use words. That means let the Spirit guide you. Like, I think it was the first time Jen spoke. I made a thing about it was being driven by the Spirit. And it was Peter that said that he was referencing a sailboat because he's a sailor. And he said, just like putting up a sail, put up your sail and let the Holy Spirit drive you where it yes. wills.
He'll open doors.
Yep.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Well, that was it. And that's the salvation of Jen. Salvation of man. We're saved. Thanks be to God, we're saved. We're all saved. And if you're not, you're saved. If you're confused or concerned or in doubt of any, please let one of us reassure you, you're saved.
Yeah.
Because we've made that commitment. I'm pretty sure we've all made that commitment here. I don't want to assume anything, but it's a commitment that we surrender our life to Jesus Christ. And let the Holy Spirit lead us where it leads us. Where his will be done in our life. We surrender, Lord. We surrender.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.